Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 4.3 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abaqus. In this example we perform a continuation analysis, which is a geometrically nonlinear analysis of an imperfect structure. We add a simulated imperfection to the perfect model in example 4.1, and then we plot the load deflection curve. By perfect we mean that in example 4.1, and in most examples for that matter, the geometry is perfect, as well as the alignment of the loads and boundary conditions, and the material is homogeneous within each lamina. In reality, no structure is perfect, but seldom anyone goes to the trouble of measuring the imperfections. First, open the CAE file from example 4.1b, and save it as ex4.3.cae. In this way we avoid most of the model generation. Since most of the model is taken from example 4.1.b, we go directly to meshing, to refine the mesh. In module job, delete the jobs that are there from example 4.1b, then create a new one, and use it to write the .inp file. Now open File Explorer. Save job1.inp, as job-pert.inp. We will use this file to compute and save the buckling modes into a file with extension FIL. We need to add 4 lines to the buckle step, right before the asterisk boundary conditions. These are the 4 lines. Insert them here. Now create a new job, to get the mode shapes written to the FIL file. This job is from an input file, not a model. Then submit. When done, the FIL file will be in the work directory, with the information that we need to simulate a geometrical imperfection. On File Explorer, we find the FIL file. Now we open job-1.inp, again, and save it as job-riks.inp. Here we have to replace 3 lines by 14 lines. Here are the lines. You can copy them from the textbook or from the files in my website. Plus the 4 lines we used before, in job-pert.inp, that have to be inserted as well, like this. Do not forget to delete all the lines related to case 2, like this. Finally we create job-riks, to perform geometrically nonlinear analysis of the imperfect structure, and we submit it. It takes a long time. When completed, click Results. To see meaningful results, we need to do more work than just visualizing the deformation for each arc length increment. We can get the arc length for each frame, but that doesn't tell us much, because arc length is not load. We have to extract the load as a function of arc length, then plot it versus the deformation as a function of arc length. Like this. Dashed lines represent the behavior of the perfect structure, as computed in example 4.2. Solid lines represent load N, versus displacement S, for two imperfection magnitudes, 1/10th and 1/100th, of the plate thickness TH. Notice that the load versus displacement response of the structure deviates more and more, the larger the imperfection is. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook by following the link in the description. Thank you.